we are going to go create a maintenance notification. The first thing you got to do is click on IW21, which you can see right here in your favorites menu. Afterwards, you got three options when you get here. This is the initial screen. Depending on the type of notification you're creating, you can create either a corrective, a maintenance request, which is a general request for maintenance, or just a report about something you've seen. The most common thing you'll probably likely raise is a corrective maintenance request. In this case, we're going to create a maintenance request for corrective maintenance, and we'll select N1. After you press this, you have a few options. You could either click here or press Enter. Once you go on to the next screen, this is a create notification screen. There's a few things you got to keep in mind. The first thing is that you need to state what you're doing, what has just happened. Afterwards, you got to put where this has happened. Then you have to put some notes. And then you have to put who has done the work, who will do the work. And at the end, you'll put some dates. So first part here is what has happened. In our case, we will say that the oven is jammed. That's what has happened. Afterwards, we're going to go look for this oven. Since the oven is a piece of equipment, we will click on equipment. You have two options here. Either you can look for a function location or an equipment. A function location is a system or a room, something that is static. An equipment is something that is not static that can be easily replaced. An example would be a telephone from a room or a board from a room. And something that's static would be the floors or the lighting system. In this case, we'll click on the equipment. We'll click here. It'll take us to this screen. We will say we're looking for an oven. And we'll press this button here, which is called the execute button, right here. Right here, we're going to select the bread oven. So what we do, we click on it, and we press it twice. We double click on it. Once you select it, it will sit right here until you press enter to register the fact that you selected the oven. In this case, what I will do before I press enter, I will delete this information here, and I'll delete this information here. Now we'll press enter. You can press this or the enter button. Once this comes up, what this screen is basically telling you what is going on right now with that specific piece of equipment selected. Is there any breakdown reports? There is no breakdown reports right now. There has been 18 notifications created. There has been 8 orders, work orders created. 11 notifications have been completed, and 5 work orders have been completed. It will also tell you the last 3 notifications raised. Bread wrapper, photo eye out of alignment, a robot, and the oven has been jammed before on this date. The last active work order is a robot. You just press enter through this. Now what we have to do is, if you are a maintenance mechanic or a maintenance supervisor and you know who's going to be doing the work, you got to pick who's doing the work right here from the main work center. In this case, we're going to select Pat LeBlanc to do the work. Now, if you are a production supervisor, most likely you won't know who's doing the work, so you leave that empty. Next, we select the required end date. This is an optional field, so only if you know when this should be finished by, you should select it. Otherwise, leave it blank. In this case, we will say that it should be done by next week, the 27th of September. You can give this a priority. We're going to say hi. This priority is always interchangeable at a later date. And then you put notes here. The oven has become jammed. Looks like the baking trays are stuck inside the oven. That is all you need to create a notification. Now you will press save. And to get out of the screen, you press cancel.